Houston Justin Verlander is not easily impressed. The Astros' new ace has won a Cy Young, pitched in two World Series, and is engaged to a Sports Illustrated swimsuit model. But there was a moment last month when the big right-hander did a double take. He was taken aback by where he was. In the first game here, I was probably in the third or fourth inning, and just in between innings, was warming up, and just happened to glance up and see Mr. Ryan sitting right behind home plate, Verlander said of his childhood idol, former Astros ace and Hall of Fame pitcher Nolan Ryan. You couldn't get me to sit still for anything, but if a Nolan Ryan game, classic game or anything like that came on TV, I was glued to the TV for however long he was pitching, which was often pretty long, Verlander said. So to see him back there, and for me to be on a big league mound in the playoffs in a Houston Astros uniform, man, it was a pretty humbling and pretty kind of full circle moment for me. David J. Philippup, that was a moment of familiarity in what has been a time of change for Verlander, who was traded by the Tigers to the Astros at the waiver trade deadline. Verlander will face the Yankees Saturday in Game 2 of the American League Championship Series. Yankees fans are well aware of how tough and old-school Verlander is, having watched him with the Tigers for the last 13 years, and twice having to see him against the Yankees in the playoffs. But these young Bronx Bombers are a whole new challenge for Verlander, who did not face the Yankees in the regular season. I haven't faced any of them. I don't know my thoughts. It's kind of a wait and see, and once I make my pitches to them, then you just kind of adjust on the fly, Verlander said before Game 1 of the series at Minute Maid Park. They have scouting reports on me, I have scouting reports on them. I think we all know our strengths and weaknesses. But you never know what a guy's going to see well, or what he's not going to see well. You just don't know that until you get out there. So that's one of those things that we'll have to figure out in the game tomorrow. Verlander last started a playoff game against the Yankees in the 2012 alcs, beating them 21. He, of course, pitched 9 innings that night. In an era of pitch counts, piggybacking and innings limits, Verlander is a competitive, old-school workhorse of an ace, a lot like his idol Ryan. Sometimes, Verlander feels like he belongs to a different generation of pitchers. He said he's been lucky that his body and muscle build has allowed him to avoid injuries. The 34-year-old thinks that he would have been able to compete with the guys like Ryan better than younger pitchers. I think the way baseball is now, you see a lot of injuries, because the minor leagues and early in guys' careers you don't weed out, the guys aren't weeded out that are injury-prone, because pitchers are babied. Don't throw too many pitches, don't do this, don't do that, Verlander said. So now you get guys that are names and they have established themselves in Major League Baseball, and then they're blowing out as opposed to kind of the filtering out process in the minor leagues. Now it's a different age and a different time in the game, I'm not saying that's the wrong way to do it. Alcs images, but to answer your question, to come back to it, I do often wonder how I would have been back then. I think it would be a pretty cool time to play baseball. Instead, however, Verlander is trying to create his own legend in Ryan's town in this new era of Astros baseball. The deal that brought him here was one that energized a high-powered offensive team, gave him a chance to do something his idol never could do here, take the Astros to the World Series, and maybe even win the franchise's first.